Renaissance Fashion by Sydney Stevens and Anne Frischella. The Renaissance period started in about 1450 AD in Italy. During the Renaissance, women typically wore an outer dress,
a skirt,
a bodice,
a chemise,
a fillet,
and lastly, the coif.
Throughout the Renaissance, men typically wore hanging sleeves,
a skirt,
hose, a jacket, a robe,
a camicia,
a beret,
and finally, the doublet. It is believed that during the Renaissance, clothes were such an important treasure because all of their earnings were spent on what they wore. Queen Elizabeth influenced the spread of fashion to other European countries such as Spain, France, Italy, Germany, Flanders, and Poland.
The wardrobes of the wealthy were augmented by fur trimmings and jewelry. Clothes became a status symbol towards the end of the Middle Ages. The noble and wealthy did not want commoners to dress like them, so they made laws that made peasants wear anything but cheap cloth and blanket. Friars wore cloaks with hoods and habits. Shoemakers often wore borealis hats and wooden coats with fur-trimmed sleeves. Nobility dressed themselves in elaborate and brightly colored robes, gowns, and other vestments. The upper class reserved silk for themselves, and in some areas, peasants were forbidden to possess it. Embroidery of gold and silver thread was used to sew designs depicting scenes from legends, nature, or religion. Wigs were crafted from peasants' hair, which were extremely popular. The wealthy were literally wearing their wealth, as the expensive clothing helped establish a reputation of wealth for the owner. Women wore long dresses that generally had high waists and puffy sleeves. Wealthy women would have elaborate jewelry made of gold and ornamented with expensive jewels such as pearls and sapphires. Men wore colorful tights or stockings with a shirt and a coat. The coat was generally tight-fitting and was called a doublet. They often wore hats as well. Blonde hair was considered especially stylish for the women. They would often bleach their hair to make it blonde. Depending on where you lived, there were all sorts of laws and rules about clothing. In some areas, only nobles were allowed to wear different kinds of furs. People were not very clean during these times. They rarely bathed and may only wash their clothes a couple times a year. A white complexion was desirable for a woman. As a result, they often wore hats or veils to keep from getting tan in the sun. Men wore many different kinds of shoes. This shoe is called the Scarpine Duckspill Leather Shoe. This shoe was the nobleman's court boot. This shoe was called the slashed leather shoe, which usually had over-contrasting colors. This is a Renaissance woman's shoe, which usually had elaborate embroidery and many different kinds of jewels. This is another shoe a high-class Renaissance woman would wear. Renaissance patterned fabric, usually velvets and brocades, were more popular than materials of single color. Garments worn by the clergy established their position within the church's ranking. Diamonds became very popular in the 14th century. Laws had been developed to control who wore what in that century also. Manor lords usually wore felt hats with stirrups and brown jackets.